I mean, we've got some very infamous distinctions, and the lowest open space ratio is clearly one of them. And according to the UDPFI guidelines, we are seeing a standard of 10 to 12 square meters per person. And then you can see some of the figures over here for Chicago, New York, London, and Mumbai is over here, 1.1, Tokyo 3.96. So that is the kind of unfortunate distinction that we are seeing in the case of Mumbai, and of course the population density, etc. Now, this is a standard feature, and which is the core theme of the subject of the report which we are releasing, that this particular aspect, morning 6 to 10, evening 3:30 to 9, and that is the kind of a thing which is repeated in garden after garden in Mumbai. This is another garden. A commentary on the aesthetics of our notice boards might be a separate conversation when I was preparing it, but we won't get into that right now. This is another very beautiful garden in Juhu. And the same feature keeps repeating itself, 9 a.m., 5 p.m. In this case, it's quite a big difference. In some cases, the standard is 10 or 4 p.m. And this is, again, a very typical feature for a whole lot of parks and gardens during this time, that there is huge amount of facility. And what we are seeing is that there's nobody to play, and they're all lying empty. And so one is that we have that infamous distinction of 1.1 meter square meter per person. So we are denying people open space in spatial and temporal scale both. And increasing physical space under gardens is difficult. We know, I mean, the development plan exercise has just gone through, and we know what a tough fight getting land in Mumbai is for public spaces. And we have a number of champions over here who've been fighting for open spaces in the city. But what we're saying is increasing the amount of time open spaces are available to citizens is a whole lot easier. And it is extremely unfair that first we deny people a per capita open space ratio, and then we also deny people, citizens, the amount of time that is available for things. And this is something which incidentally also got covered in the wonderful report and beautiful picture that we have of Cross Maidan today in the papers. And this is a scene outside Sambhaji Udyan in Santa Cruz West, one of the areas also where we close. So the garden is clearly closed. Now the interesting thing is that this neighborhood over the past 5 years has transformed into becoming a hub of garment work. And most all of these people are people who are working in the garment factories. And they have very tight working schedules. 1 to 1:30 or 1 to 2 is the only time that they get to come out, where they are having their lunch, whoever wants to smoke, chit-chat, etc. And these are the kind of scenes you're seeing where the park is just not available for them. And this is a park which has been adopted by Reliance Energy, like a lot of other parks have been adopted by various private concerns. And this is how people are sitting. They are sitting on the footpath. This is another same site from the other direction, all of them having to sit. The barbed wire on top adds another very awful kind of a commentary to the way we treat citizens, etc., and the kind of commentary on that is separate. But this is what people are getting, and right behind is a beautiful garden which is lying completely closed. Again, this is a very famous landmark. This is Joggers Park in Bandra. Very beautiful across the city, very beautifully landscaped, manicured. But if anybody were to go there during the daytime, those hours, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, that is what you would face, an open gate. That's what stares in your face. we're clearly seeing that there are number of user groups for whom this whole thing of taking a walk in the morning or in the evening is not feasible. For some people, at 11 o'clock, at 12 o'clock noon might be the only time that they have when they can go to an open space, and they cannot go there. And of course, our malls, like we've commented in our report, are open as many hours. And in fact, in malls, we try to increase the number of hours. In gardens, we are shrinking the number of hours. This is another very beautiful, this is a 5-acre garden in Andheri West, Kamlakar Valavalkar Udyan, maintained privately by a developer. If you go during the daytime, it's lying completely empty. That is the view you will get from the boundary wall looking inside. Somebody, a Mali, a gardener, is landscaping it, etc. But you will not see anybody inside. Empty benches, empty play areas. This is in Hiranandani complex. So very, again, beautifully done up garden. But anytime you'll go during the daytime, it's lying empty. And we can see that there is a huge cluster of buildings, and not necessarily that everybody will be in offices at this time. And there might be people. Also in our report, we've argued that one of the points which was made was it gets extremely hot during the daytime, which is a valid argument. But 3 months during whatever we call as winter, December, Jan, Feb, the weather is extremely pleasant. People can very well be outside. During the monsoons, when it is not raining, the weather again is very pleasant. And so for 6 months almost, we are seeing, and a lot of these have very good green cover, which means there is shade. This is at the other Veer Kotwal Udyan, again lying completely empty. And interestingly, this garden is in the midst of a very bustling area. Plaza is on one side, the other station. Continuous traffic at any time of the day or night. And this is during the daytime, unfortunately, nobody can use it. And the same site will repeat itself. People will be all standing along the periphery and having chit-chat. They can very well be sitting inside and relaxing, but it's not available. And then this is a beautiful, I mean, I find this picture very beautiful. This is Cross Maidan. And it's such a wonderful sight that this family, and I actually had an interaction with them. They were not from Mumbai. So they just, they were carrying some snacks with them, etc. And they had come to visit somebody, and they found this garden close by. And they were more than happy that I take their picture. And it would have been good to invite them for this meeting today, but I didn't have any coordinates with them. Hopefully through the media, we might be able to reach them. So they were very happy to pose for this, and it was a beautiful sight. And this is just 10 minutes walking from where we are, and of course maintained by Oval Trust and Nagar. This another picture is of the Honimal Circle Garden. Again, a very beautiful experience when you go there at any time. This is again, these are all daytime pictures. This could be during the lunchtime. That is a classic kind of a site where people are sitting. And another very typical feature over here is that a big user group is the salesmen, credit cards, mobile phones, etc., who are servicing the whole area. And typically what happens is all of these people are carrying their lunch boxes with them. Even going to an Udupi is very costly. And not just costly, I mean, from a health point of view, people carry their tiffin, but there's absolutely no place where they can sit and eat. They cannot go to their clients' offices and say, okay, I want to quickly have my dabba. And then on the streets, there is, of course, no place. So Honiman Circle Garden becomes an excellent place for them to unwind. And some of the people also decide to take a quick nap. And I don't think there should be anything wrong with that, even though some of the gardens we've been visiting as part of our survey have very strict things. You cannot sleep, you cannot sit on the lawn, you cannot walk here, you cannot do that. So, and that's why these two gardens have really formed the basis for our comparison, that we don't need to look to New York, to London, to Chicago, to Tokyo. We have some excellent examples within our own city. And all that we need to do is, but again, since we have to look global, and because we have world-class aspirations and we want to become a global city. This is one of the most famous examples that we have, which is Central Park. And Central Park is open from 5 a.m. in the morning till 1 a.m. in the night. And any time of the, especially of course this is summer, this is the kind of a site which you would find at any time of the day or night, where people are completely making the most of the weather, and you could be strolling in and out of Central Park at any time. There's no restriction. We had a wonderful team of urban planners, architects in the morning, 3 hours we spent in the same room, wonderful discussions, and so I decided to carry. This is one of the most popular parks in Amsterdam, and you can clearly see people are having a great time. This, I mean, I was quite surprised to know that in Europe, parks are open 24/7. I didn't know that. So at any time of the night, day, you can just be going there. These are some of the more, for the Indian audience, I mean, some of the pictures I saw, there was high level of nudity. People were completely comfortable with that. People were drinking. I could see some people rolling a joint. So all kind of things from the same park, which couldn't be carried over here. But the fact is that, okay, at some point people have become mature and they're kind of becoming accommodating for much more things. So this was a standard kind of a matrix with which we ran through this case study. Honiman Circle, Cross Maidan, Kamlakar Valavalkar Udyan, Rao Sahib Patwardhan in Bandra, Veer Kotwal, and Sandhyaneshwar Udyan and Veer Baju Prabhu Deshpande Udyan, which is next to Chaitya Bhumi. If you've ever been to Chaitya Bhumi, on the right-hand side is this very beautiful gardens. And Chaitya Bhumi draws tourists from around the state. And all that they get to do is visit Chaitya Bhumi, and they cannot access this garden at all. It's closed. And this was the matrix. We said, how is it managed? Is it managed by a private trust or by BMC? Is it open through the day or not? Is there an entrance fee? And what are the kind of restrictions? So if I can just take you through two comparisons. Hanuman Circle Garden is managed by a private trust. It is open through the day. It does not charge any entrance fee. And it allows people to eat, sleep on their lawns. And that has in any ways not impacted how it is maintained. It is beautifully maintained, very well maintained. And if you were to just compare that with a very popular garden in Bandra, this is very close to Linking Road, Rao Sahib Patwardhan Garden. It is managed by a private trust. It has, again, the same restricted timings. Interestingly, it is charging an entrance fee. It is charging 5 rupees as an entrance fee, whereas Hanuman Circle Garden is not charging any fee. And eating, sleeping is certainly not allowed on the grassy areas, lawn areas. In some pockets, yes, but not. So this is what we ran it through. And we visited some 30 to 50 odd gardens. All our team members are here. Karishma was, of course, part of the team, but Aparna, Radha, some other team members were there. And we visited a lot of these gardens. And the same story keeps repeating over and over again. So these are the kind of arguments in a very nutshell that we are driving towards keeping parks open. I mean, I think it's a sign of a much more equitable society. Neera Adarkar today has not been able to join because she had to rush up somewhere, but in my conversation with her, that's the point she was driving, that this whole thing of keeping it open in the morning, in the evening, is very symptomatic of the urban educated elite, which will be in the office during the daytime, and for the time it is in the office, it doesn't want other sections of the society defile their kind of area. So it should be kept pristine when they walk in the morning or in the evening. And so nobody wants poorer people, etc., to be coming in and spoiling the whole space. So that's one kind of an argument. So we definitely, it's a more sign of a more equitable society. And then the point which you're making, that certain user groups clearly find it very difficult to come before 9 o'clock. A lot of senior citizens we were speaking to, they said that because of health issues, getting up in the morning can be an issue. Maybe by 11 o'clock is the time when they can actually visit an open space, and 11 o'clock it is closed, and in the evening there might be some other restrictions. So that's one user group. And then, of course, we are saying, great, we have world-class city aspirations for more than 2 decades now, first Singapore, then Shanghai, and of course many other cities along the way. And we clearly know that most world-class cities are how they are going. And again, during the conversations, we said, what are the problems? Why keep them closed? And these were some of the things, antisocial elements, drug addicts taking over, gambling, people taking it over for gambling, beggars. There's a big problem with couples. That seems to be like a thing that, oh, we can't get couples in at all. That's a big issue. And overall security. People felt that, and there is, I clearly feel there's an exaggerated fear on most of these accounts. But of course, not to say that I'm dismissing the concerns which people have, because like we know, and during the panel discussion, I'm sure Naina will be speaking about it, that there are issues with drug addicts, etc. And I really didn't know that the problem with drug addicts is so severe in the city till I got into the open space timing issue. So these are the problems. And roughly during our interactions, we also felt that, okay, if it is desirable, I mean, we're just kick-starting the discussion right now. Just last week, I was with a senior politician in municipal corporation speaking to him about it, and he point-blank said, no, we will completely oppose this. And he immediately introduced me to two contractors. One of them said he will definitely come, but I can't see him in the audience. And he said, we will be the first people to oppose it. Between those two contractors, they were managing around 100 BMC gardens, including the one next to Chaitya Bhumi, which I just mentioned, the Baji Prabhu Udyan. And he was very proudly saying that, see what a beautiful job I've done. And it is a beautiful job. And he said, then you'll keep it open during daytime and people will come and spoil it, etc., etc. So he said, I'm going to be the first one to oppose this whole policy of keeping it in the open. So we have some that kind of a thing. And hence, we need a strong community desire and participation. The two gardens which you've taken as a case study speak far more about the people who are staying in the neighborhood, and especially the trustees of Oval and Nagar and Honimal Circle Garden Trust, and their ethos and philosophy towards how a neighborhood's open spaces should be maintained. So I think community desire, local community desire and participation will play a big role in keeping these gardens open. And then, of course, community and MCGM collaboration is extremely critical, where at the senior level, middle, lower level, and of course, a few spirited individuals pushing the matter at local levels, which is what we are seeing in the case of Cross Maidan. Public meetings, consultations, and involving politicians and creating the right kind of a political will. Because again, just to come back to the previous points, the importance is clearly felt in terms of the beneficial aspects of open spaces on public health. More than a, this is not an environmental issue, this is not a open spaces issue or some kind of a competition with other cities in the world. We're clearly seeing that access to greenery, being in open spaces, being able to relax. Also in a city which is so dense, which is so stressed, constantly on the move, that this is actually a public health issue more than an open space environmental or a governance issue. And from a public health point of view, we're really arguing strongly for this. So that's it. I don't want to introduce many more points. Please feel free to stay in touch with us, and we can... Yes, Karishma was part of the study, and yes, you'd like to add.
I have two, three things to tell, which when I used to go to the gardens. So, I went to Maharshi Karve Udyan, which is in Vadala, and I went at 11 o'clock, and I saw boys going inside the garden, and I entered, and they said that you're not allowed, and I said that boys just entered, and they said, no, girls are not allowed. So there are timings, during 11 to 5, when girls are not allowed, but the guys are allowed. A garden in Andheri, I saw a small boy defecating in the garden. So there are these two, three points which a garden, it's so beautiful and people are not able to use it. But the slums around, are people who are living in the slums are using it to defecate. So, and... the major points that when I used to talk to the BMC officials regarding the timings issue, and they always mentioned it to me saying that the gardens have to be closed because you need to maintain them. But I know it's a bit difficult to maintain the gardens during, if they are open during the whole day. But I think we need to push ourselves more and we need to take more maintenance charges, but we need to keep the gardens open. So that's all I have to say. Yeah.
Thank you. So we'll invite you over. We can now sit and start the panel discussion.